Lots of people want the same thing out of a park.
Parks have to be more fun.
To have fun, and some people take going to the park as relax.
With the modern stresses and strains of everyday life, parks are essential as an escape.
You want to go and chill out with your friends. Oh, I think it's really nice to have a park around your area.
Yeah, because it's soft and when you fall down,
it's our home park, so it gives us confidence.
Yeah. Me and my friends, like, we just go to the park, like, we chill and play football, and after, like, other people come and join, and after we just socialise and become friends.
People were sitting out there having sandwiches on the grass, and little family groups of children kicking the ball around with mum sitting there watching them.
I mean, I used to hang about down here with my friends when I was young, so seeing my children come down here as well is really nice.
It's better to sit in the fresh air than sitting at home in walls all the time.
We're going to engage with the community, we're going to bring the kids into the parks. That aids the crime diversion, it takes the kids off the streets, puts them in a safe environment.
It just makes me feel like I belong there and everyone around there is just so friendly.
All of those boxes we are ticking now.
We're filling a gap in people's lives and making a difference.
Show progress, you know, we want people to see things being done. And that's how you get people on board, when they see things being done.
Everything that's happened in the park or changed in the park has been done through consultation with the community.
And we were saying, what do you want? What do you want? Do you want this? Do you really want that? Why do you want that? And people had very positive ideas about what they wanted here.
We want our environment to be a very nice place.
This is actually one of our parks that has got the Green Flag Award, but we want to maintain that. We want to get the Green Flag Award again and again and again, and getting the community involved. They'll have this pride in the community. It'll be their park.
And it's nothing that children can't sort of be brought into doing from a young age. And then they realise, and it doesn't become a problem. It's just because things have been left and neglected that people don't see the need for it anymore.
Anybody who comes here, once they see this park, this is, oh yes, this is the place where we can do what we like to do. People are cycling in this park because this is the park where you can cycling, you can play anything, you can even enjoy around the pond. There's so many things going on.
Litter has been identified as a problem in the public in general, so we just thought that would be a good start to the campaign. So today we're undertaking tasks such as litter picking, pruning, painting railings, generally to improve the park and also encourage people to use the natural facilities that we have available here.
So I'm here today to support all the community in their endeavours to recycle and reuse.
Have like wood and plastic and that, and when people find it, they should stick it in the right one. The council can come and take it.
And what we find is that if you give people that opportunity, give people that chance, they grow it. They want to make their communities greener, cleaner, safer places to be.
And everyone's very concerned about the state of litter on the streets and everything like that. So all the more we can do to try and make it a better and cleaner environment is worthwhile.
And the kids just really went to it with gusto, so it's been great.
And everyone who's attended has said that they've had a great day.
Considering that we're growing up, we need to learn to not throw rubbish on the floor.
And it was quite fun, I thought it was quite fun.
So it's been fairly successful.
My name is Abu Usaid and I'm a community sports coach for Culture and Community from London Borough from Newham.
This is the second time we're running holiday courses in Kenning Town, and as you can see, it's been really successful. So while we're working in partnership with the parks to get the change in program, and have courses like this, it would be quite easy for young people to access a lot of goals and other equipment to use, and consulting everything we do in partnership with the local residents.
I really enjoy going with my friends over to the park in the grass area and running about. We were discussing how the park wasn't really very good. And then they listened to us and they improved it by putting a place for running.
We planted bulbs and we did this glitter thing on the pavement.
I like that they have thought about the little children and put a play area in, a lot of swings and slides and that.
and we tell them that it's definitely a really fun park for children.
It's really imperative that you talk to those kids, it really is. And the youth clubs, I'm pleased that they're doing that. And I hope they do listen to them, I really hope that they do. They go up with a sense of responsibility and a sense of ownership. And that's something you really need, sense of ownership.
I think that you could put more dog poo bins in there and try and keep the play area clean.
If you've got a dog, then it's your responsibility. You clean it up, there's bins everywhere.
And I think that there should be more paths leading. You have to walk across the mud if you want to go.
The bad thing about the park is that they only do games for like a park for younger children. They don't do like a bit of a park for older children.
And as you can see, it's very babyish, especially for our age and the people that's behind us.
This bit of the playground here has been here for a couple of years now, so I think they should change this one into our older one.
Swings and slides and climbing frames and better things than what's here already.
I love this place. This place is excellent.
You let the kids own this and you'll see the difference, because it's part of their, you know, it's theirs. Lots of things the council do I don't agree with, but yeah. Lots of things they do I do agree with. You know, they don't get it right all the time, but when they get it right, we need to say, yes, they're getting it right, because it's very important. And, yeah, they are getting it right.
Because a lot of the time, people aren't doing anything wrong. They're just, you know, hanging out in a group or just looking. People are just scared now, I think.
People don't know them, can't talk to them, and we hold events like this, but the main people we want to talk to aren't coming in here, and so they aren't heard.
They'll dress the same, but most in lads and the girls, once you get through the little bit of bravado, good as gold, just normal kids.
I wouldn't be in favour of police patrols, because that tends to criminalise everyone, makes everyone feel as if they're being watched.
There are 52 parks and open spaces in them. We do the parks and the open spaces. You're going to get a bit more antisocial behaviour in the summer than you do in the winter. It's in the summer, they're packed out. Certain things are restricted to certain age groups. Your drinkers, which tend to be the older ones, and the younger ones are just doing generally naughty things. Our number is on the gate. You phone them and they'll put the call out to us. And hopefully we'll be able to attend in time.
Lots of people go there to exercise more now. That's new.
If they had more exercise in equipment and stuff, people would rather be outside in the parks than at home.
Put some investment into that, make it a better place, so people will want to go there and play sports.
Asphalt to football pitches.
We're looking at putting in a new third generation football pitch into the park, and that will improve the rugby pitch and a football pitch. Through that, we've written a football development plan of how we're going to engage with young people. We've also doing some work with the rugby club to engage with that and try and, because at the moment we don't actually have a lot of young people involved in the rugby club.
Loads of trees, beautiful, colourful plants, loads of wildlife. It just makes you feel more relaxed.
It was apparent in our first consultation that people did want more wildlife, so proposed that mowing regimes were changed. Really easy way to get the park to be more wildlife diverse.
As a community, I think that if people saw that it actually wasn't just a dump, they'd consider it as their own.
The public should be allowed to own their parks. They should be able to take pride in their parks.
Making them feel that they love their park is sort of what we're trying to do.
Environmental clubs, planting clubs, litter clubs. As a community, we should keep that park.
Local people can basically sign up to be involved in events, and, you know, actively involved in events and so on.
Some of the parks have what they call Friends of Parks, groups of people who really want to get on board and come forward with suggestions. Other parks, we haven't quite got round to setting up in that sort of way yet. It will come, I'm sure. That's something that Newham's really got to get down to.
We want local residents to continue to support the park service, support the development of the park, and we want them to have a direct say into things like these plans, these proposals for improvements. We want them to continue to make us accountable to them. It's just a really good, effective way of them keeping an eye on what we're doing, and this is what we want them to do.